blood, sweat, tears, it's a calling. And if I can't walk, then I'm crawling. It might flicker, but they can't kill the flame.
God Goal family, it's all about that movement today. As we talk about movement, as you can see, I got my hat on, my umbrella hat, and I'm ready for the beach, baby, because there ain't nothing that sun can do to get me sunburned today, because I am protected. And if you're going on a beach trip this summer, I'm telling you right now, this is the way to go. It's stylish, got some beautiful colors here, all the colors of the rainbow. Roy G. Biv, for those of you who know. And also, it protects you from all the rays of the sun. So you got to get on that. But after that word from our sponsors, we're going to talk a little bit today about movement. What I told you, we were going to be going into this series of movement. How do we move forward in our lives? How do we move past things that we've been struggling with? How do we get better? How do we make those moves that we've been trying to make for so long but couldn't make on our own? We got to look first at how we were able to move into this position we're in right now as followers of Christ to start with. Where do we look first for movement? Well, I'm going to show you real quick. And you're going to be a little bit surprised. I got a feeling. John 3:16. Oh, yeah. You know that's right. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. That verse right there is so popular. It is the foundation to all of our beliefs, all of our faith, and all that we believe, because it is the gospel. It is the gospel of Jesus Christ and the good news of what he's done for us and how God loved us so much that he sent his only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, shall not die, but have eternal life. That's pretty awesome. You see, that's the gospel that saved my life. And the gospel, if you're watching this as a follower of Christ, the gospel that saved your life. And if you're not, even better, because that gospel can save your life too. But this gospel, we want to look at how can we move forward. Well, we're going to go on a little road trip, and we're going to talk about ways that we can move forward. But first, like with any car, we've got to find out how do we find the fuel to get us there. How do we find the fuel in our lives to move us forward in our car? Because like any car, if we don't have fuel in the gas tank, then we can't move forward, right? And if we run out of fuel, how are we going to move anywhere? How are we going to go anywhere? For us to move forward and make that movement in our lives happen, we have to first start back where God moved us to start with. When we were moved to see the truth of the gospel and moved to see the love of God as he saved our lives through his son, Jesus Christ, as he gave him up as a sacrifice for our sins. And he moved us from death to life. He moved us from darkness to light. He moved us from our old lives to a new life in Christ. See, God made that movement happen from the beginning, but we can't just leave it there. Because I know if you're like me, I grew up in church. I've heard John 3:16 100 times. And I like to think that, man, I know it word for word. I can recite it. I don't need to know anymore. But I'm telling you guys, we're going to dig into that a little deeper, but it's more than just what we see on the surface. We got to dig a little deeper and find out if I'm going to move forward, then I got to have the fuel to make my engine go and get there. That I got to have the fuel to make me move forward. And it starts with the gospel. It starts with the gospel of Jesus Christ, because if it moved us forward once and saved our lives, it will and can move us forward again. So today, I'm just going to give you that, John 3:16, and it is the root and the foundation of what we see as movement in our lives, because it's not about us. And you see, that's what this gospel is all about. This gospel says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. See, without God loving us that much to give up his son, and for Jesus to make that sacrifice on the cross for us, we wouldn't have a way. We would be stuck without gas. And what happens when you have no gas? You can't move forward. You're stuck. You're stranded. And I had that happen to me recently out in the middle of the lake at my wife's friend's house. We got stuck in the middle of the lake, no gas, and we couldn't go anywhere to do anything. But what happened You know, I even thought maybe I can get out and I can save us. Maybe I can move the boat forward and get us back to where we need to go. I said, maybe I can jump out, grab the rope, and pull the boat as I swim. And I was like, no, that's not a good idea. I shouldn't do that. But the truth of it was, someone had to come and bring us gas and save us. Someone else had to come and save ourselves on that boat as we were stuck and stranded without fuel. Just as Jesus did for us when we had no way out, when we were stuck on the boat with no gas, we were dead and we had no way of moving forward, moving to God and having a relationship with Him and having the life that He gives us. We were stuck in death and we were going to perish. But then God saw our need. God saw that we couldn't do it on our own, that we couldn't save ourselves. So He sent His Son to save us, to give us the gas that we need to get that movement going and saving our lives, put us on this road that we're going to travel down these next few weeks, the gospel road, and we're going to see how we can move forward. But first, we have to know that fuel that moves us forward, that fuel that causes movement to happen in our lives, it starts with the gospel. It starts with verses like John 3:16 describing what Jesus did for us and who He is. But first we have to see that it's all about Him and not about us, because we can't do it. Only He can. So like He saved our lives once, the gospel isn't something we move on from. It's where we stay as followers of Christ. So as He saved our life once and moved us, that's what He can do again today if we go back to the gospel and start at the gospel. So our first stop on this journey is the gospel. So I hope that encouraged you today. I hope that moved you forward in some way. Stay tuned, because the messages are going to keep coming and they're going to keep digging in more to this series. Love you guys. Hope you have a great day. See ya. Till the wheels fall off, till the spotlight fades.